Hey guys, Chris here. So today I'm going to do a head and heart tutorial, Lost in My Mind. You guys have been asking me to do this for a while, and I'm sorry, I'm just now getting around to it. I didn't have internet for a while, now I do. So let's get down to business. Let me throw this out here before all you YouTube haters start getting crazy out there. I'm not a guitar teacher. I don't claim to be. I am an amateur guitarist myself. I still consider myself a beginner. Taught myself. So before you start criticizing my every move, just wanted to throw that out there. So this song is actually great for beginners. It only has four chords, and the chords are a D, a G, there is an A major played, I think, twice, maybe three times, and then there's a B minor played once, which is a bar chord, which is the hardest part in this entire song, but it's not even that hard. Everybody tries to shy away from bar chords because it takes so much finger strength. But in actuality, it really just is a lot of technique. Yes, strength definitely helps, but hopefully I'm going to show you a little something that might help you along with your bar chords. The way that I play bar chords, so you don't have to just rip down on the guitar and just grip it, I use leverage. I take this hand, this arm, and I push out on my guitar. So if my hand wasn't there, my guitar would be going out this way. So I'm taking my hand and pulling back on my guitar. Well, I take this hand and I'm pulling it back. So I'm pushing my guitar out and pulling my hand back. So I don't even need my thumb to play a bar chord. So let me go ahead and get down with the chords, show you the chords real quick, and then we'll just jump on into the song. So the verse is going to be, it's going to start out on a D, which is going to be your first finger on the G string, second finger on the high E string of the second fret, and your third finger is going to be on the B string of the third fret. You're going to want to mute these top two strings, because it sounds nasty with them in there. See, it sounds more of a happy, bright major chord. So wrap your thumb around it if you can. If you have smaller hands, just skip that. And then it's going to go into a G, which everybody should know a G major. But if you don't, I'll explain it. Going from a D to a G, you have a common finger, which is this guy right here. It stays on with the same chord, or the second chord, so just pivot. Just throw this pinky down and throw these fingers up. Don't take your hand off and try to find a G chord. Just keep that finger there and just pivot. It makes it a lot easier. So it goes from a D to a G. D, back to a G. And then there's a couple times where they play an A major, which is all on the second fret. It's going to be the D string, the G string, and the B string. There's actually like three different ways that you can play this. You can cram all your fingers in on these strings, which I can't do it because my hands are so big. So I like to wrap my hand. Let's see if we can get a good shot of that. Maybe not, but so you can do it that way, or you can bar it. Just make sure you mute this top E string out. You don't want that one in the A. And then it goes into, there's one B minor played, which is this. So you're going to mute again the top E. You just kind of touch it with your top finger, and you're going to bar every string. You're going to take your second finger, and you're going to place it on the B string of the third fret. Third finger is going to go on the D string of the fourth fret, and the fourth finger is going to go on the G string of the fourth fret. It's going to sound like that. And then strum pattern is down, down, up, up, down, up. So it's... So it's... To a G. Back to a D. So it's, we'll go. And let's go ahead and cover the strum pattern for the chorus as well. And you can do the same strum pattern throughout the entire song. For me, it gets a little monotonous. So I just throw some down strums in to kind of get a little different, you know, sound. So it's the, how's that brick thing come? Well, how's that big thing coming? How's your engine run? Is that bridge getting built? Are your hands getting filled? Won't you tell me, my brother? 'Cause there are stars. And then I start strumming here. Up So you get the idea there. Let's see. Oh, and then there's one song when one part of the turnaround where it kind of goes into the lost in my mind, which throws in a B minor, which I'll show you here in a second because I just remembered I forgot to show you where the A is played. So it starts off. It goes. Put your dreams away for now. I won't see for some time. I am lost in my mind. I get lost in my mind. My once told me you're already home and you feel love. I am lost in my mind. I get lost in my mind. Ooh. Don't you worry about me, we're going to an A. Don't you worry. Back to a G. Don't you worry. Don't worry about me. To a D. Okay, so you get that. You get the idea. Pretty simple, pretty repetitive. Just listen to the song and figure out what goes where, put all the puzzles, the pieces together. But I'll show you where that B minor is thrown in. It goes, how's that brick thing coming? How's your engine run? Is that bridge getting built? Are your hands getting filled? Won't you tell me, my brother? We can start moving forward to an A, to a G. 1, 2, 3, all right. All right, so should get the idea. I hope that helped. If it didn't, let me know.